Maryland, one of our smaller states, irregular in shape, sandwiched between the great Commonwealth of Pennsylvania on the north, with its metropolises of Philadelphia and Pittsburgh, and the nation's capital on the south. Still, like the biblical David, little Maryland is small, but oh my. It has the Atlantic Ocean lapping at its eastern shore, with long white beaches and summer weekends that become lifetime memories. It has the Chesapeake Bay, its surface a playground for sailors, its depths the home of oysters and crabs that gourmets and pundits have celebrated from H.L. Mencken to Paul Bocuse. It has the mountains of western Maryland. And it has Baltimore, whose inner harbor has been transformed from a navigable cesspool into a major tourist attraction. The same harbor in which the Star Spangled Banner was written one night long ago. And Maryland has something else, the thoroughbred horse. They've been racing in Maryland since a Virginia breeder named George Washington used to send his horses to the post in Annapolis. And every May, the Preakness Stakes hold center stage as the middle jewel in the Triple Crown. Maryland's white-fenced green fields have been the breeding grounds for champions. Native Dancer roamed the pastures of Sagamore Farm. The world's most famous stallion, Northern Dancer, rules the fields of Winfield's Farm today. And this weekend at Laurel Racecourse, another bit of racing history begins in Maryland. Hello, I'm Jim McKay, speaking to you this time not as an ABC sports commentator, but as the president of a new racing event called the Maryland Million. During the next 2 hours, you're going to see nine races. That's right, nine races in 2 hours for horses of both sexes and all ages, competing for a total prize money of $1 million. All of the horses must be the progeny of Maryland stallions. There's never been an event like this in any state. It's come about through the cooperation of all the groups involved in Maryland breeding and racing, from sponsorship by corporations, both Maryland-based and from elsewhere, and by cooperation from the state itself. Most important, it's an exciting day of racing and a day for you to join us, the people of Maryland, in celebrating our state's most beautiful product, the thoroughbred horse.
Thoroughbred Sports and ESPN present Racing Across America. Today, live from Laurel Racecourse in Laurel, Maryland, it's a historic day in Maryland racing. The Maryland Million is brought to you by Budweiser. V20H for that clean, crisp taste. This Bud's for you. Lanes In, home of seven stallions, two champions, including 1985 Horse of the Year, Spendebuck. By the Thoroughbred Art, your invitation to equine excellence. First Jersey Securities, a nationwide investment firm. Come grow with us. Three Chimneys, the idea is excellence. By the Omni International Hotel, we put the more in Baltimore. The Ryland Group, Ryland homes are built for life. And by Valvoline Motor Oil, where motor oil is not just motor oil. Stay tuned to be a part of history. 2 hour coverage, nine races next on Maryland Million Day at Laurel.
This is the home of the world famous Clydesdales, a symbol of Budweiser's long tradition of quality. The finest ingredients, beechwood aging, and a special touch of care and pride. No other brewer has such a tradition of quality to live up to. But then, no other brewer makes the king of beers. After all, this Bud's for you.
Racing now through November 16th at America's fifth largest racetrack.
Desire. The desire to win. It's something you're born with. In the blood of every great competitor, you'll find a burning desire for victory. Reaching farther, going faster. Walmack International. Winning the world over.
The laughter of children, the warmth of holidays, the serenity of still autumn mornings, a place to rest and dream and grow, to be secure. The people of Ryland understand what makes a house a home. That understanding strengthens our commitment to build homes of quality, value, and integrity. Ryland builds beautiful, affordable homes in lovely communities all across America. For the Ryland community nearest you, see your local paper. Ryland homes are built for life.
Well, the state of Maryland and this historic Laurel Racecourse that observes its 75th anniversary this season has never quite seen a day like this. This is Maryland Million Day. And hello again, everyone. I'm Chris Lincoln as we welcome you on across the country here on ESPN to the state of Maryland. And what a big day it is for the state of Maryland, a historic day of racing. We're glad to be part of it. You know, this is the 21st stop on our 22-stop series, Racing Across America on Thoroughbred Sports. Certainly the most challenging, because in the next 2 hours, get your race program ready. You're going to be with us for a full day of racing at Laurel. 9 races. 4 we'll cover live, 5 we'll have you taped earlier today. Let's give you the conditions now first of the Maryland Million. For those horses that are eligible, they must be the offspring of nominated Maryland stallions standing in the state of Maryland. With that in mind, 182 stallions were nominated for the very first year of the program. 80 horses entered, and of the 80, to show you the quality of racing in the state, 30 are stakes winners. Well, Dave Johnson's going to be with us along with Tom Dawson, our experts. We're going to bring Dave in right now to talk about the 9-race program. And Dave, our host Jim McKay, you know, it was his dream back in 1984, Breeders' Cup won. Today, it's about to come true.
Well, Jim's million-dollar dream became a million-dollar reality today. And McKay's been described as the carburetor on the engine of this whole thing. And the vehicle is bringing outstanding racing, not just here to Laurel, but across the country. And let's take a look at the race schedule for this afternoon. We have the Distaff, which is a 6-furlong handicap for fillies and mares. Then we have the Lassie at a mile for 2-year-old fillies. The Nursery at a mile for 2-year-olds, followed by the Ladies, a turf race for fillies and mares. Then the Maryland Turf for 3-year-olds at a mile on the turf. Then we have the Classic at a mile and a quarter for 3-year-olds and up. The Oaks for 3-year-old fillies at a mile and an eighth. And the Sprint, which is also a handicap, 3-year-olds and up at 6 furlongs, and the Maryland Handicap, mile and an eighth, the backbone of racing, claimers in here, 3-year-olds and up, who had started for a claiming price of $15,000.
Well, all we have to do is be their form and be their program today, and along with the story, of course, this race, the bloodline, the Stallions of Maryland. And to give you more on that story, let's go to the Wind Circle and our colleague Tom Dawson.
And Chris, speaking of backbone, it's the Stallions that are the backbone of the Maryland Million program, as it's their nomination that triggers everything that happens later. There were 129 of those Stallions you mentioned who had runners old enough to participate today. When you think of Maryland breeding, the first name that comes to mind is Winfield's Farm. And of course, at Winfield's Farm is the home of the Great Northern Dancer at age 25, still amazing, the world's most commercially successful sire. And here you see his beautiful surroundings at Winfield's Farm. And there's the 25-year-old Northern Dancer. He's got a couple in today that have some good chances to pull off wins here in this Maryland Million. And of course, at Winfield's, he does not stand by himself. There is Smartin, the good 10-year-old, very versatile sire of both speed rather and stamina. He has several chances here to win today. And of course, they're not the only ones. All over the state, Lord Gaylord at Worthington Farms, the leader today with 8 nominees. Shelter Half, a brilliant young sire. He has 5 in today. Dancing Count from Shamrock Farms, a son of Northern Dancer with 4 starters. Double Zeus, the son of Spring Double, with 4 today. John Alden from Bonita Farms, who has 2 in the Eskimo Pie Ladies. And Horatius, high on the list of leading sires in Maryland in 1986. And of course, there are many others from all over the state here participating today. And Chris, some of those are going to get a little better known because of the exploits of their offspring.
Thank you, Tom. And we come back, we'll have our first live race setting it up, the state of Maryland Distaff, when we return to Laurel.
Has a 5-length lead. Natani is second with Soldier.
Thoroughbred racing. It can be more than just a spectator sport. The experienced and successful management team of Thoroughbred American Racing Consultants, Thoroughbred ARC, are ready to make you a participant and owner. Thoroughbred ARC brings together the best horses and the best horsemen to get you into the winner's circle. Racing and selling thoroughbreds for profit. Find out how you can win in the sport of kings with Thoroughbred ARC.
I'm Frank DeFrancis. Last fall, we promised to build you a sport palace. And we did. We created the ultimate in action entertainment. applauded by the national news media and racing fans everywhere. And now, continuing toward our goal of racing to be the best, we're spending over $1 million on a clubhouse facility worthy of our fans. Plus, our $15 million in purses will bring you the best in racing.
Who says America has run out of opportunities?
There are plenty to look for them. The people who built this country were doers, not doubters. Risk takers, seeking opportunities, not guarantees. Today, I still see vast opportunities in hundreds of small to mid-sized companies whose entrepreneurial spirit and energy will continue to build America. At First Jersey Securities, we specialize in discovering such emerging growth companies for today's investors with vision. First Jersey Securities, come grow with us.
Imagine Virginia's beaches. Imagine Florida's sun. Imagine New York nightlife. Massachusetts history. West Virginia's hills. Now, imagine a vacation that offers all this and more within one state. Because while you are imagining these wonderful places, you are actually seeing Maryland. There's more to Maryland than you can imagine.
Well, what makes Maryland Million Day successful? Well, of course, has been tremendous corporate sponsorship, but look at the fans as well. What a turnout on the first Maryland Million Day on a beautiful fall day in Maryland. Crowd of over 20,000 expected. They'll bet more than $2.5 million is the expected pool today. Let's take a look now at the conditions of our first live race we'll cover for you today. It is sponsored by the State of Maryland, their tourism division. It is the State of Maryland Distaff Handicap. That means it's for the fillies and mares, 3 years old and up. They'll be going 6 furlongs, $100,000 in the purse for the State of Maryland Distaff Handicap. Now let's go to Dave Johnson and check out the field for the Distaff. Dave?
We have a field of 10 here going 6 furlongs on the fast track, and number one is Joan R. with Jesse Davidson riding, and 10-1. Stay Home with Red Hot Apprentice Alan Stacy is 4.5-1. Northern Nibbles, one of the long shots, with Anthony Nuez 60 on the tote board. PJ's Blitzen with Carlos Barrera is at 50-1. Mrs. Pumphrey, the 5-horse Danny Wright rides, and 20 is the price. Angelic Lady with Paul Nicole Jr. is 30-1. Now the 6-5 favorite is number 7, Cap It Off, with Jerry Bailey in for the riding assignment and carrying top weight of 122 pounds. Masked Barb is the 8-horse with Alberto Delgado, 3-1. Two Lindas with Wayne Barnett, 6-1, and Wee Lavalier with Frank Lovato Jr. is 35-1. Field of 10, and the big horse in here is Cap It Off, the 7-horse with Jerry Bailey. This horse has lots and lots of early speed. You're taking a look at the 7-horse right now. Easy to follow in the red and white colors. Cap It Off last raced on a sloppy track up at the Meadowlands in the Ski Pat Stakes, but was in front at part of the way, but has had most of his success right here in the Maryland circuit, winning by open margins in many of the encounters. It is interesting that the second choice is Masked Barb, who's been really running in long races. Masked Barb was a winner at a mile here in the Parasol Handicap in June. But that was a mile. This is sprinting. They have to be quick out of the gate. The third choice is Stay Home, the 2-horse with Apprentice Alan Stacy, who's giving 10 pounds, no apprentice, but 10 pounds to the no apprentice allowance in the stakes race. That's why the carrying 112 pounds. The track record for 6 furlongs, 108-3, set back in 1980 by Secret Emotion. So that's the field for this, the sixth race on the card. We're going to be taking a look at the earlier races on tape right now. Let's go to the top of the stands and the track announcer for Laurel. Here's Robin Burns.
Thank you very much, Dave. Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. A beautiful day here at Laurel Racecourse. The weatherman has cooperated beautifully, and the jet stream didn't play any tricks on us today. And the field for today's sixth race is now being loaded into the starting gate. We've got Joan R. loaded in there nicely, along with Stay Home having a little bit of a problem here with the 3-horse Northern Niblets. And the handlers are having their hands full with her going in. They finally have her into the gate. The 5-horse will go in next. That's Mrs. Pumphrey. And then we'll wait for the balance of the field to go in. Angelic Lady, the 6-horse with Paul Nicole, will be loading next. And there goes the speedy filly, who is the favorite right now. Number 7, Cap It Off, with Jerry Bailey, who has already won one of the races on today's program. She's the even money favorite. Next in line will be two Lindas, and then we'll wait for the Philly wearing saddle pad number 10, Wee La Valier. They're all in line. They're off in the distaff handicap. Two Lindas on the outside is going to the front, cap it off quickly between horses. Along the rail, Joan R with PJ's Blitzen. Three horses are out for command. Cap it off on the outside, leads by a head. Joan R along the rail is second. PJ's Blitzen between these two fillies, third. Off from between horses, here comes Mrs. Pumphrey. Two Lindas on the outside is fifth. Stay Home is now sixth along the rail. Northern Niblets is seventh between horses. Angelic Lady, Mass Barb, and We Love Allaire. The quarter, a quick 22 and 2. They're sprinting midway on the turn. Cap it off on the outside. Gets the lead by a head. PJ's Blitzen is second by a length and a half. Moving up on the outside. Two Lindas is into third. Mrs. Pumphrey is fourth. Jonar is dropping back. Stay Home now looks to get on track. Jonar on the far outside. Mass Barb, We Love Allaire, and Northern Niblets. The half in 46 and 2. They're into the stretch. Cap it off. And Jerry Bailey have the lead by a length and a half. Two Lindas. The gray filly on the outside is now closing with a rush. They're inside the final 70 yard. It's Cap It Off in two Lindas. Stay Home is third. Cap It Off in front. Seven Cap It Off wins it by about a half a length. Number nine, two Lindas second. Two Stay Home third. The running time here, 1:11 and 4/5.
Thank you, Robin, and it is Cap It Off, the unofficial winner, the number seven horse ridden by Jerry Bailey, the horse that went off at even money today, and Jerry Bailey riding to victory for C. Oliver Goldsmith. The Bay Philly is trained by Gregory L. Wilson. A photo sign is up. A photo sign is up. We kind of agreed, though, with Robin Burns' call, the seven horse Jerry Bailey and Cap It Off. We'll be back to Maryland to make things official here. As you take a look, the beautiful Waterford Trophy of the Maryland Million.
Cheshire Kitten has a five-length lead. Natani is second with Soldier.
Thoroughbred racing. It can be more than just a spectator sport. The experienced and successful management team of Thoroughbred American Racing Consultants, Thoroughbred ARC, are ready to make you a participant and owner. Thoroughbred ARC brings together the best horses and the best horsemen to get you into the winner's circle. Racing and selling thoroughbreds for profit. Find out how you can win in the sport of kings with Thoroughbred ARC.
I'm Frank DeFrancis. Last fall, we promised to build you a sport palace. And we did. We created the ultimate in action entertainment. Applauded by the national news media and racing fans everywhere. And now, continuing toward our goal of racing to be the best, we're spending over $1 million on a clubhouse facility worthy of our fans. Plus, our $15 million in purses will bring you the best in racing.
For a half a century, we have been part of thoroughbred racing worldwide. The thoroughbred runners bred here have won more than 8,900 races, valued at more than $55 million. Our farm is the established world leader as a breeder of stakes winners, more than 300. We stand for quality, for confidence, for excellence. We are Winfield's Farm, celebrating our 50th anniversary.
The laughter of children, the warmth of holidays, the serenity of still autumn mornings, a place to rest and dream and grow, to be secure. The people of Ryland understand what makes a house a home. That understanding strengthens our commitment to build homes of quality, value, and integrity. Ryland builds beautiful, affordable homes in lovely communities all across America. For the Ryland community nearest you, see your local paper. Ryland homes are built for life.
Well, while the three-year-old and older fillies and mares come back from the distaff, just run here live here on ESPN, we're going to take you back earlier in the day today, race at 1:30, and to a younger group of ladies. This is the USFNG Maryland Lassie. Again, the purse, $100,000. The distance is 1 mile for the two-year-old fillies. And let's take a look at the group of fillies now with Dave Johnson.
And as they start to move into line, which is run, the one-mile event run out of a chute, here's the field. We have a very powerful entry from the King Leatherberry stable of Edgar's Girl and Short Fuse Susie. Short Fuse Susie has won her last three starts. 1-2 on the tote board for that entry. Greg Hutton rides Short Fuse Susie, and the leading rider of the meet so far, Edgar's Girl, is ridden by Donnie Miller Jr. Then we had Sheltered Star. Then we have In the Curl, the three horse at 25-1. Yield to Reason is 70-1. And In the Curl, the great horse from the one of the fine horses from the Meadow Stable. Yield to Reason, Smart Halo, who is undefeated in two starts, and Miss CG with Greg McCarron on the outside. Let's have Robin's call.
They're off. In the US F&G Maryland Lassie, taking the lead from between Philly, Short Fuse Susie, In the Curl, moving up on the outside second. Smart Halo coming on third. Edgar's Girl along the rail fourth. With Sheltered Star on the outside, Miss CG and Yield to Reason. Down the backstretch. In the Curl on the outside lead, Short Fuse Susie by a head. The opening quarter in 23-2. About five lengths separates these fillies racing down the backstretch. Part of the 1-2 entry, Short Fuse Susie has a short lead. In the Curl is right alongside in second. Here comes the Canadian filly moving up on the outside, third, Smart Halo. Along the rail, Edgar's Girl is fourth. Miss CG on the outside with Sheltered Star and Yield to Reason. The half and 47 and 4 continuing down the backstretch. These fillies are still well bunched. In the Curl on the outside leads by a head. Short Fuse Susie is second, three parts of a length. Moving up on the outside under confident handling, Smart Halo. Sheltered Star is now coming on. Edgar's Girl, Miss CG, and Yield to Reason. They move to the top of the stretch, three quarters and 13 and 4. They're fanning out four wide on the drive to the wire. In the Curl on the outside now pokes ahead in front. Short Fuse Susie is dropping back. Smart Halo is in the center. Sheltered Star on the far outside now looming boldly. They've got a 16th of a mile to run. In the Curl continues to lead. Smart Halo on the outside. Smart Halo pokes a nose in front.
So Smart Halo remains undefeated with a win here in the US F&G Maryland Lassie, coming from off the pace to take it. And joining me here now is the trainer of this fine filly. This is Jim Day, based in Canada. Jim, she had two real nice races up there before coming down here. Did you feel that the mile distance would suit her?
Tom, I thought that she's maybe a little bit short of seasoning to come here and run a flat mile, but the Maryland Million came up today and we didn't have any time for more races, so we had to run today and take our chances.
Did the race come up about the way you thought it would, with the pace and her laying just off of it?
There was some speed in the race with Short Fuse Susie and In the Curl, but they didn't want to be like really fast speed horses. They were, you know, looked to run along on the lead, but probably backing the pace up a bit. So we ended up being pretty close to the pace, just about a length back most of the way around, and made our run through the stretch.
Now at this point, you are making your run, and there was an objection filed here by the rider of the second place horse. Any anxious moments?
Well, anytime there's an inquiry, it makes you awful nervous. But an actual fact that filly In the Curl was coming out rather than our filly coming in, so it turned out that there wasn't anything to it.
Very good, and there she is at the wire, putting ahead in front with a good come-from-behind effort. Thank you very much, Jim, and good luck with the rest of the day.
Thank you very much, Tom, and look forward to seeing you again.
Thank you very much. And here's the results of the US F&G Maryland Lassie. Smart Halo, the winner in 139-3, returns 540, 440, and 210. In the Curl was second, 1360 and 210. And the favorite was third, Short Fuse Susie, returned 210. And the remaining order of finish. There you go with Smart Halo, In the Curl, Short Fuse Susie. Sheltered Star came from off the pace to be fourth. Edgar's Girl was fifth. Miss CG sixth. Yield a Reason seventh. And that's the results of the US F&G Maryland Lassie.
And making the presentation, Mr. Jack Mosley, chairman of the board of US F&G Insurance, and Mr. Miroslav Havel, the chief designer from Waterford Crystal, who created all of the Maryland Million trophies. Smart Halo, winner of our first race, the US F&G Maryland Lassie. Those are the results. We'll be back with our Maryland Distaff Handicap results in return as the Clydesdales are here.
Strength, pride, tradition. For centuries, the Clydesdale has been known as a special breed. Today, the Clydesdale Clydesdales symbolize Budweiser's dedication to quality, superior ingredients, exclusive Beechwood aging for a distinctively clean, crisp taste you find only in the King of Beers. Dedication to quality. You know what it means because it shows in everything you do. Quality taste, because this bud's for you.
And welcome back. The first race you saw live with us here today was the State of Maryland Distaff Handicap, and here are the results in the payoffs. Cap it off, winning it in 111 and 4, paying 4, 320 and 260. Tolendis was second, and Stay Home was third. Those are the results of the Maryland Distaff Handicap. Let's take another look at the stretch drive with Dave Johnson.
Cap it off, bolted right out of the gate, went to the front, and as they turned for home with about 3/16 of a mile to go, Jerry Bailey, who's aboard the filly, gives her a couple whacks with the right hand, switches to the left hand, and home free, carrying 122 pounds the entire way on the front end and holding off the opposition. Two Linders, who's trained by Hank Allen, who will be trying to win the big race later on this afternoon, finishes second with Stay at Home, the Allen Stacy horse, who had been bet down to 9-2, getting show money. But there it is, cap it off, the winner by about a half a length. And here's Tom Dawson.
All right, Dave. Greg Wilson, trainer of the good filly Cap It Off. You really pointed her for this race, didn't you?
It was our main goal, was to win this race here today.
Now, in her last start, I believe it was, she had a good deal of trouble.
Well, she ran a race at Saratoga. She finished second, got beat a nose to Jean's Lady, and was the track was really heavy that day, and she blew both front shoes, but she still ran a very game race.
And at that time, that's when you knew you really had your class filly.
I knew she was a good horse after that race.
Greg, congratulations on a great effort, and pointing for this race sure seemed to pay off for you.
Thank you, I appreciate it.
You bet. Greg Wilson, the trainer of Cap It Off, the winner of the State of Maryland Distaff Handicap.
And let's take a look at the winners now. The presentation made by Governor Harry Hughes of Maryland and the Secretary of the Department of Economic and Commercial Development, Mr. Thomas Maddox. Let's take a result now. The 6-furlong Maryland Distaff Handicap for you. Cap It Off, Tolendis, Stay Home, Mass Barb, Angelic Lady ran fifth in the Distaff today. Then it's Mrs. Pumphrey, PJ's Blitzen, Wee Lavalier, Joan R., and Northern Niblets. Rounds out the results there for the Maryland Distaff. We'll be back with more racing from Maryland when we return in 2 minutes to Laurel Racecourse.
Nothing makes your day like helping others make it on their own.
You bring out the pride we all feel inside.
It's going to be easy next week.
It's more than just a job you do.
Work.
Here's to you, Beechwood Aged, for that clean, crisp taste that says Budweiser.
This bud's for you.
We blend lessons from the past with the latest technology to make Lane's End in Versailles, Kentucky, the ultimate thoroughbred farm. Horses and humans alike enjoy the ambience at Lane's End, but that's not why we do it. The Lane's End Thoroughbred Breeding and Development Program, begun more than 25 years ago, has earned the respect of knowledgeable professionals the world over, but that's not why we do it. The Lane's End Stallion roster includes champions such as Kentucky Derby winner Spendabuck and proven sires such as Sovereign Dancer. It is a pleasure to stand such fine thoroughbreds, but that's not why we do it. We do it to win.
They're bred in Maryland. They've beaten horses from around the world. Churchill Downs, Ascot, Pimlico. Today, a new tradition begins, the Maryland Million. Next year, it continues at Pimlico.
Well, the co-feature coming up for us, the Eskimo Pie, Maryland Ladies Saddling going on in the paddock. That's number six, Dismasted. That's the big horse. It's 6-5 on the morning line when the fillies and mares 3 years old and up. And you can see just how crowded the paddock
Maryland
is. Million Day. But before we get ready to see some of the older horses go on our co-feature, we're going to take you back to today's second race on our program. Let's take a look now at the conditions for the juveniles as they take over the spotlight. This is in the Juvenile Colts Maryland Nursery, $100,000, sponsored by Business Express. The two-year-olds will be going 1 mile. And to set the field, here again is Dave as the horses approach the starting gate to load.
Another 1 mile event, and another entry starts it with Elchi Doe and First Special, Steve Barton and Wayne Barnett, the jockeys respectively, and 12-1 on the number one entry. Then we have First Patriot with Jimbo Bricciali and Yet Wave with Jean-Luc Samin at 4-5. First Patriot has faced some of the best two-year-olds in the country, including Gulch and Polish Navy. Then we have Local Pride with Paul Nicole at 35, Sutton Flair with Jerry Bailey at 9-2. We also have a scratch, the morning line scratch, Grand Roll. And leaving us with Lord Herman, a maiden who's getting some support bet down from 6-3-1. That's the field, and we'll go to the top of the stands now, and here is the call of the Business Express Maryland Nursery with a $100,000 purse for two-year-olds. Here's Robin Burns.
They're off. The Business Express Maryland Nursery. Away slowly, Elchi Doe. First Patriot takes the lead on the outside. Sutton Flair now rushing up along the rail second. Yet Way between horses third. Make Music is fourth. Local Pride toward the rail. They swing out of the clubhouse, turn and race down the backstretch. From between horses, First Patriot has the lead by a length. Sutton Flair along the rail is second. Yet Wave on the outside, third. Between horses, Local Pride is fourth. Moving up on the outside, Lord Herman in between horses, First Special. Along the rail, Make Music. Continuing down the backstretch. Sutton Flair gets the lead by a head. Between horses, second, First Patriot. Moving up on the outside, Yet Wave the third. Lord Herman is now fourth. Majestic Friend dropping back along the rail. Moving up on the outside, First Special. Make Music to the outside. Dropping back along the rail, Local Pride and Elchi Doe. The half in 47-4. They now move to the top of the stretch. Sutton Flair has the lead by a head. First Patriot is right alongside in second. Yet Wave is third. Lord Herman on the outside with First Special in between horses. Make Music dropping back, Local Pride. Three quarters in 113, they're into the stretch. First Patriot has the lead by two lengths. Sutton Flares along the rail second. Yet Wave is third. In between horses, Make Music fourth. 70 yards to go. First Patriot leaving the field.
And William Rickman's First Patriot, the handy winner of the Business Express Maryland Nursery. And joining me here in the winner's circle, rider Jimbo Bracciali. First time you've seen this colt.
Well, yeah, it was the first time I seen him today. And I talked to Mr. Juggins this morning a little bit about the horse, and he helped me out, and the horse did the rest.
Now, you were head-and-head for the lead all the way on the turn. The inside horse moved upright to you. Any anxious moments thinking you might not have enough horse left?
Well, no, at that point, Mr. Juggins had told me this morning that the colt has natural speed. If I could keep him clear and save a little horse at the same time, he thought he'd run real good, and he broke real sharp. I made the lead real easy, and when that horse challenged me, I had pretty much horse underneath of me. The other horse was looking to me like he was getting tired, so I wasn't too much worried about him. I was just hoping nobody could run and catch me.
And they certainly didn't with that fast last quarter. Good luck on King Swan later in the card. Congratulations.
Thanks a lot.
Jimbo Bracciali, rider of the winner here in the Business Express Maryland Nursery, the favorite First Patriot, $360, $260, and $3. Sudden Flare, $360 and $340. Yet Wave coupled with First Patriot with the same prices. The running time, 137 and 2, 2 seconds faster than the filly race.
And making the presentation for our second race winner, First Patriot, the president of Business Express Airlines, Mr. James McManus, and the senior vice president of Delta Airlines, Mr. Whitley Hawkins. The winner of race two, First Patriot, sired by the Maryland sire, Salutely, and by the way, one of his shareholders, our host, Jim McKay. We'll be back with live race coverage coming up, the Eskimo Pie Maryland Ladies, when we return to the state of Maryland.
For the thoroughbred racehorse, the road to the winner's circle is paved with uncertainties.
For almost two decades, the people of Hull & Smith horse fans have helped remove some of those uncertainties. Year after year, Hull & Smith has safely traveled millions of miles, hauling thousands of thoroughbreds closer to the winner's circle. Hull & Smith, still the safest and surest trip to the winner's circle.
Omni Hotels, serving the great cities of America, are known for their distinctive service and distinguished style. And the Omni International Baltimore is no exception. Located in the heart of the financial district, only four blocks from the famed Harbor Place and National Aquarium, we're ready to serve you with 714 handsome guest rooms and a variety of affordable weekend packages and group rates. For reservations in Baltimore and other fine Omni hotels coast to coast, call 1-800-THE-OMNI.
A dream is born. And with care and attention, discipline and freedom, the dream begins to come alive. Share the dream. Let thoroughbred racing come alive for you.
Announcing the Valvoline 4-Guard I Love a Parade sweepstakes. Win a trip for four to four of America's greatest parades. To enter, watch the next commercial and remember what the driver of the smoking car says. Then go to a participating store for details.
Big parade this year.
It's the economy.
Oh, Russell. Russell, what kind of motor oil are you using?
Motor oil.
Motor oil definitely is not motor oil. A four-cylinder engine works harder and needs the extra protection of specially formulated Valvoline 4-Guard.
Not much to afraid this year.
It's the economy.
Oh, Russell!
And a look live at Laurel Race Course here in Laurel, Maryland. And of course, you see not only the dirt course, but the famed turf course. It'll be the site of the Washington, D.C. International. We'll be back for that in the middle of November. As the horses are on the track now for our next live race for you, it is the seventh race on the program. The co-feature, the $150,000 Eskimo Pie Maryland Ladies. It is on the turf, a mile and a 16th for three-year-old and up, fillies and mares. Now to take a look at the field for the Eskimo Pie Maryland Ladies, here again is Dave.
Chris, this is a real nice bunch of distaff turf specialists. Current odds show the Cheshire Kitten with Jerry Bailey is at 12-1. Martin's Choice with Paul Nicole Jr. is at 19. The three horse with Alan Stacy Turn to TJ is 8-1, started at 12, so getting a little support there. Lady Emerald with Carlos Barrera, 25-1. Etta Carnier with Mike Hunter is up to 14. Dismasted is the big favorite. Jean-Luc Samin rides and 1-2. You put up two, you get one, plus your two back. So it's the big favorite. Alden's Ambition with Jesse Davidson is at 5-1, and a Joyful Spray with Larry Saumel, 14-1. The major contenders in here, though, has to be started with Dismasted. And let's take a look at Dismasted. We see her on the track now, and she was on the track at Belmont Park September the 13th in the Flower Bowl Handicap at a mile and a quarter in a Grade 1 race. Now, the leader at this point was Cope of Flowers, but watch Dismasted on the outside with Jean-Luc Samin and the yellow and black silks of Edward P. Evans. On the rail, Bill Shoemaker brings Scoot right on through. And at the wire, these two fillies finished on even terms, a dead heat with Dismasted and Scoot. But that day, weight was certainly important. Dismasted carried 115 pounds in the Flower Bowl. Scoot only 106, so you have to think that Dismasted was the better filly, carrying 9 more pounds. Today, 122 pounds for the three-year-olds in this contest, and the older fillies and mares carry 126 over the mile and a 16th on the sod. Now, if this were on the dirt, maybe Cheshire Kitten would be favored. Cheshire Kitten right there is the number one horse with Jerry Bailey. This horse, owned by Scott Savin and trained by Sonny Hine. Let's watch Cheshire Kitten in action back in January at Gulfstream Park in the mile and a 16th Swanee Handicap. The Kitten was four wide coming into the lane in the green colors. Again, Jean-Luc Samin had them out here. But as you can see, Cheshire Kitten is just going to draw away by three. Watch, Samin. He had switched from his right hand, the whip, to the left hand, then back to the right. The filly certainly responded in the Swanee. Now, if you think that jockeys are pretty good handicappers, well, then you have to choose Dismasted, because Samin did not take the mount on Cheshire Kitten. Jerry Bailey picked it up. Dismasted gets Samin this afternoon. Another one of our contenders is the 8-horse, A Joyful Spray. And let's take a look at the Joyful Spray in action. The big gray ghost in front was Kitty Tatch with Donnie Miller. Watch Donnie, he's going to look over his shoulder and under his arm, watching for A Joyful Spray, who's closing stoutly, and this was a good effort. But not good enough that day, maybe good enough this afternoon. She certainly likes the turf, maybe better than she does the dirt. Since that race that we just watched, A Joyful Spray was sixth, but only beaten 3.5 lengths in the Laurel Budweiser Cup Handicap, but had a lot of trouble in that race. So if you like horses who had some trouble, well, this might be the horse. Started at 10-1, and as I look over now, he's up to 16. She certainly is. He certainly maybe might be a bargain at 16-1, A Joyful Spray. But I have to go with Dismasted. I think that she's a model of consistency. She likes the turf. Jean-Luc Samin's an outstanding rider. So I would have to go with Dismasted.
All right, Dave, and we're going to take a look now at the current odds for this $150,000 co-feature on the Maryland Million Day program, the Eskimo Pie Maryland Ladies. Cheshire Kitten again at 15-1, Martin's Choice 21-1, Turn the TJ 10-1, Lady Emerald 25-1, the big prices there. Etta Carinae is 16-1, the 5-horse. Here's the big favorite. Dismasted is 1-5 with Jean-Luc Samin. The number 7 is Alden's Ambition at 6-1, and the 8 is A Joyful Spray at 16-1. There's the field. Those are the latest odds. When we come back, we'll be ready to run the Eskimo Pie Maryland Ladies as you take a look at the Harbor of Baltimore.
This is the number of the ultimate winner's circle, a lifestyle dream you can make come true. This is Del Rio Estates at Rancho Santa Fe Farms, California, just north of San Diego. These luxury estate lots are measured in acres with a view that's priceless. The San Diego Valley offers a panorama of breathtaking beauty. From the famous Dwayne Lucas and Del Rio Racing Stables to 3 championship golf courses and beyond to a view of the Pacific. The number to call for Del Rio Downs. 65 luxury homes to be built in a totally secure development. 2- and 3-bedroom floor plans range in size from 2,500 to 4,000 square feet for those who appreciate the thoroughbred way of life. From the morning workouts to the time in the pastures to the racing at Del Mar and nearby Hollywood Park and Santa Anita. Make it a part of your lifestyle. Only at Del Rio Estates and Del Rio Downs, Rancho Santa Fe Farms, California. Write for this free brochure or call. Join us in the Ultimate Winner's Circle.
Desire. The desire to win. It's something you're born with. In the blood of every great competitor, you'll find a burning desire for victory. Reaching farther. Going faster. Walmart International. Winning.
The laughter of children, the warmth of holidays, the serenity of still autumn mornings, a place to rest and dream and grow, to be secure. The people of Ryland understand what makes a house a home. That understanding strengthens our commitment to build homes of quality, value, and integrity. Ryland builds beautiful, affordable homes in lovely communities all across America. For the Ryland community nearest you, see your local paper. Ryland homes are built for life.
Well, the sun is slipping through the clouds here in this absolutely beautiful fall afternoon here at Maryland. The ladies have not as yet taken their position, heading over onto the turf course. This, the Eskimo Pie Maryland Ladies, the co-featured on the Maryland Million program at $150,000. There you see the gate for the mile and a 16th race. And to continue to handicap this race, let's go to Tom Dawson for his opinions.
Well, Chris, I certainly have to agree with Dave Johnson that Dismasted is definitely the horse to beat today. Her 1-5 price proves that, but a couple of interesting possibilities here. Here's one of them. This is Alden's Ambition. She's a 5-year-old mare by John Alden, who has 16 wins on the dirt. She's been first or second in her last five starts, although she was disqualified last time out. She has limited turf experience, but she should be close to the front end here today, and in fact could make the running during the early part of the race. The big question is whether or not she can last with a runner like Dismasted into the race as the race gets down toward the wire. But Dismasted, definitely the favorite. Another interesting possibility, Martin's Choice, owned by the Gildebob Stable, a partnership of Gilbert and Robert Moore and Dean Reynolds, formed expressly for the purpose of buying Martin's Choice. She's been a real hard knocker, wins her share, but she seems to run better on courses other than the course here at Laurel.
Good prices on everybody except the six filly. Let's take a look once again. Cheshire Kitten is up to 18. Martin's Choice, the horse Tom just talked about, at 25. Turn to TJ 11. Lady Emerald is 25. Etacarine, the five horse, is up to 18. Dismasted 1-5 now. Really the prohibitive favorite. Alden's Ambition 6-1. A Joyful Spray is at 15. There is Exacta wagering on this race here at the track, so if you like Dismasted, maybe you want to play some Exacta.
This is our first turf race that we've had a chance to see here today. And Dave, it always brings back memories to hear, of course, the big race on the grass, the Washington, D.C. International. We were here on an un-Maryland-like day with the rain. The watchman Landingham win last year and spurred him on to a title.
It was not a firm turf course last year for that one, but it is today. Firm track. And let's take a look at the course record for a mile and a 16th on the sod. Apollo 9 holds it. Hunt 1 minute 40 and 3/5 seconds. That was set 13 years ago, back in 1973.
And you see they're loading up now. Cheshire Kitten is in, going in the number four horse. That's the bay mare Lady Emerald, sired by Lord Gaylord. Moving in right beside is Etta Perrinet, the number five horse. Here's the favorite, Dismasted, the six horse. Watch those yellow silks and yellow cap as they go to the top of the stands. And Robin Burns.
Thanks a lot, Chris. We've got one more to go in, Alden's Ambition, and then a Joyful Spray. They're all in line. All standing nicely and about ready to go. They're off in the Eskimo Pie, Maryland ladies, Alden's Ambition. Sprints clear on the outside with a Joyful Spray second. Between horses, Dismasted is third. Ranging up on the outside, turn to TJ. Martin's Choice between fillies. Cheshire Kitten along the rail, Etta Carine. And the early trailer is Lady Emerald. These fillies and mares now sprint around that clubhouse turn, race to the back stretch, and the early leader by about two lengths is Alden's Ambition. A Joyful Spray is second by a length and a half. The prohibitive favorite gains along the rail. That's Dismasted, who is racing third. Turn to TJ, now ranging up on the outside, fourth. Gap of three, Cheshire Kitten is fifth, followed by Etta Carine on the outside, Martin's Choice along the rail, and Lady Emerald. The quarter in 23, the half in 47. They have a half a mile to run in the Maryland ladies. Alden's Ambition continues to lead by a length and a half. Here comes a Joyful Spray in the second. Three wide on the outside, and going right after the leaders comes Dismasted. A gap of three lengths, turn to TJ is fourth, followed by Etta Carine, Lady Emerald. Cheshire Kitten is dropping back in Martin's Choice. Three quarters in 12 and one, they move to the corner pole. Dismasted on the far outside now sticks her nose, her head, her neck in front. Dismasted gains command. Alden's Ambition along the rail with a Joyful Spray in the center. Here comes Etta Carine with some late foot between horses. Turn to TJ on the outside. A 16th of a mile to run. Jean-Luc Samin goes to work on Dismasted. She holds way. A Joyful Spray, a second. Dismasted win the Eskimo Pie Lady. Number six, Dismasted wins it. Number eight, a Joyful Spray second. Looks like five, Etta Carine third. The running time here, 1:44 and 3/5.
All right, thank you much, Robin. It is Dismasted, just as the folks here figured, at 1-5. But hey, if you had the Exacta, you might not have done bad. That eight horse, the Joyful Spray, was 15-1. As you see Dismasted gallop up, owned by Edward P. Evans, trained by P.G. Johnson, ridden by Jean-Luc Samin. Your local stations stand by. We have a local break coming up on ESPN, then back to Laurel.
This is the number of the ultimate winner's circle, a lifestyle dream you can make come true. This is Del Rio Estates at Rancho Santa Fe Farms, California, just north of San Diego. These luxury estate lots are measured in acres with a view that's priceless. The San Diego Valley offers a panorama of breathtaking beauty. From the famous Dwayne Lucas and Del Rio Racing Stables to three championship golf courses and beyond to a view of the Pacific. The number to call for Del Rio Downs. 65 luxury homes to be built in a totally secure development. Two and three bedroom floor plans range in size from 2,500 to 4,000 square feet. For those who appreciate the thoroughbred way of life. From the time in the pastures to the racing at Del Mar and nearby Hollywood Park and Santa Anita. Make it a part of your lifestyle. Only at Del Rio Estates and Del Rio Downs, Rancho Santa Fe Farms, California. Write for this free brochure or call. Join us in the ultimate winner's circle.
Well, there you see the number six horse just smashed it. The unofficial winner of our co-feature, the Eskimo Pie Maryland Ladies, fillies and mares three and up, going a mile and a 16th on the turf. And Joyful Spray, the number eight horse, was second. Etta Carini, the five horse, listed as third as we're waiting for official results. We're going to take a look back earlier in the day to another race here on the historic turf at Laurel. And this, as we check the conditions, is the $100,000 Ryland Group, mile and a 16th, Maryland turf. It's for three-year-old fillies, or should be three-year-old colts. Let's correct that right now. It is the Maryland turf for three-year-old colts, sponsored by the Ryland Group and Dave Johnson. Let's set it up.
Actually, it's for three-year-olds. We even have a filly in this field. Here's the field. Icelander will start from the number one hole with Alan Stacy. Lord's Wish in number two at 60-1. Icelander at 22. Rollicking Redskin with Paul Nicole Jr. 23-1. And Air Dancer is the filly with Rick Wilson and 9-1. Then we have Glow, the big favorite, trained by Woody Stevens, who's having what a year. Jerry Bailey aboard and 1-5 on the tote board here for the Ryland Group Maryland Turf. Marching Lard is 25, Mike Cantwell at 50-1. Where's Bob? Jean-Luc Samin rides the eight horse trained by H. Allen Jerkins.
They're all in line.
All in line. We have a field of eight, $100,000 purse for three-year-olds.
Here's they're off to the Ryland Group Maryland Turf. Marching Lord on the outside goes to the front. Rollicking Redskin rushing up along the rail. Glow in between horses. Third Icelander is fourth. Where's Bob? Close up into fifth. Mike Cantwell, the filly Air Dancer, and Lord's Wish. Field of eight swings around the clubhouse turn. Rollicking Redskin has the lead by a length and a half. Marching Lord on the outside, second by a head. Glow between horses, third. Icelander is with the leaders in fourth. Gap of two, Where's Bob is next. Mike Cantwell on the outside. Lord's Wish between horses and Air Dancer. Straight enough for their run down the back stretch. Rollicking Redskin has been joined by the favorite Glow on the outside. These two matching strides for the lead. Rollicking Redskin, three parts of a length. Under the snug hold of Jerry Bailey, Glow is right alongside in second. The quarter in 23-2, the half in 47-1, past the half mile pole. Rollicking Redskin and Glow are still going at it. Where's Bob? Moving up on the outside, third. Icelander is now fourth along the rail. Marching Lord, Mike Cantwell. Here comes the filly Air Dancer on the outside and Lord's Wish. Three quarters in 1, 12, and 3. Glow on the outside now gets the lead. Glow in front by a length. Where's Bob on the outside? Rollicking Redskin along the rail. Air Dancer on the far outside with Icelander along the rail. Mike Cantwell, Marching Lord, and Lord's Wish. They're into the stretch. Under a steady left-handed whip, Glow continues to lead. Air Dancer on the outside is coming on second. They're in deep stretch. And the son of the great Northern Dancer, Glow, is in a runaway. Glow in front.
And winning just like a 1-5 shot ought to, Glow adds to his victory in the Saranac earlier this year with an impressive win in the Ryland Group Maryland Turf, winning off by himself after stalking the pace most of the way. And winning rider Jerry Bailey, that's just the way you like to see him on a 1-5 shot.
Yeah, that makes it a little bit easier on the heart.
He had no problems during the race at any point.
Not at all. I figured to be maybe second or third. I didn't think that other horse would be on the lead. I thought it would be number seven. But in any event, I was where I wanted to be, and he responded when I asked him.
And here he is, as we see him on the isolated replay down the lane. He responded when you went after him left-handed.
Yes, he drew off on the other horse, although he was lugging in just a slight bit. He straightened out and ran true and straight, and there was no problem.
Thanks, Jerry. Good luck the rest of the day.
Thanks a lot.
And the results here are now official for the Ryland Group Maryland Turf. The winner was Glow, returning 240, 220, and 210 as a strong favorite. Number four, Air Dancer, second, $3 and 210. And number eight, Where's Bob, after breaking very slowly, finished third at 210.
And making the presentation of the Crystal Bowl, the chairman of the board of the Ryland Group, Mr. C.E. Peck, for the Ryland Group Maryland Turf, won by the big favorite, Glow. When we return to Laurel, we're going to stay right here. We'll stay right here at Laurel Race Course, and we'll take a look at the prices for the Eskimo Pie. Maryland ladies dismasted, 260, 220, 220. This is the race we just covered for you live. A Joyful Spray was second, and Etta Carinae was third. Dismasted, the even money favorite, and Dave, she sure showed in our co-feature. Let's take a look at it wire to wire as Dave Johnson describes it for you. The Eskimo Pie with an ISO look at the favorite, Dismasted.
Ridden by Jean-Luc Samin, Dismasted had ticked off two stakes victories coming into this race, having been victorious in the Drum Top Handicap and in the Flower Bowl. We saw that little dead heat there. As you can see, she's not a front runner. Samin is so good in terms of getting position early, saving ground around the first turn. So we're watching. They moved around the clubhouse turn. Samin had his filly content there in third, not willing to challenge the issue at this point. As you can see, he's got quite a bit of a hold on the filly and quite a bit high in the stirrups. She's running very well, though. Relaxing form up on the outside. The three horse turned to TJ with Alan Stacy makes a run. But Samin just watches the first two and then begins to inch up on the other horses. A Joyful Spray, who's eventually going to get the play spot, is right there with Larry Salmel, the eight horse. And Alden's Ambition, who was first out of the gate with Jesse Davidson, has led every step of the way until now. As they move to the far turn, Samin doesn't mind being three wide. He knows he's on the best horse. Everybody here did too, 1-5. But it was Alden's Ambition at the rail and a Joyful Spray putting up a pretty good effort here between horses and Dismasted on the outside. So turning for home with about 3/16 of a mile to go, Dismasted gets to the front, a little urging, trained by P.G. Johnson and ridden by Jean-Luc Samin, bearing out just a bit through the lane. And a Joyful Spray here holding gamely. As you can see, the whip being switched from the right to the left. That shakes a filly up sometimes. And here comes the wire, and here comes Dismasted. And here comes Tom Dawson with Jean-Luc Samin. Tom?
Here is the winning rider, Jean-Luc Samin. What were your instructions going into this race?
Well, Mr. Johnson just told me to lay right behind the speed, you know, which the speed was a 7 horse. We took a look at the paper this morning, and I just did that.
When she started to move up down the backstretch, was she doing that pretty much on her own?
She really was, yes. Mr. Johnson got her very sharp, and she really was going very easy in the backside, and she took the lead around the turn there, and she really ran a good race.
Down the stretch, you had to get after her with a whip a couple of times.
Yes, I had to, because the sun is shining right at us, and she was looking at it, and the sun blinding her, so that was a trouble. But I had just to keep up a little bit with the whip, and she did that well.
Now, she was carrying 126 today, picking up 9 pounds off her previous win in the Flower Bowl. Was that of concern?
Well, that's another reason why I had to keep up the last part. Keep up to, you know, that's what the reason I hit her a couple of times.
A job well done. Congratulations on a good ride on Dismasted.
Thank you very much.
Jean-Luc Samin, the rider of Dismasted, the winner here of the big Eskimo Pie Maryland Ladies.
All right, thank you very much, Tom. Again, some of the crowd are more than 20,000 here at Laurel. And we've got five races down, four to go, another hour to come from Laurel.
Chiefs crowd is surging. Gate Dancer is closing boldly on the outside. Proud Truth, he was last down the backstretch. He's taking it to the leader. It's Gate Dancer in front. Proud Truth is right in front. Proud Truth on the outside. Gate Dancer is game. Proud Truth ahead. Gate Dancer goes to a driving finish. Proud Truth has won it.
See 7 championship races for $10 million on Breeders' Cup Day, Saturday, November 1st.
For a half a century, we have been part of thoroughbred racing worldwide. The thoroughbred runners bred here have won more than 8,900 races, valued at more than $55 million. Our farm is the established world leader as a breeder of stakes winners, more than 300. We stand for quality, for confidence, for excellence. We are Winfield's Farm, celebrating our 50th anniversary.
Hall of Fame trainer Jack Vanberg on horse nutrition and winning.
We've used calf manna by ManaPro for a long time now. We use it at our farm, on the babies, on the brood mares, and at each of our racing stables we use it.
Here comes Gate Dancer.
Well, what I like about it the best, I think it keeps your flesh on your horses. And it's very strong. It's got the milk background in it. We love calf manna by ManaPro because it does a great job for us and works for us.
I'm Frank DeFrancis. Last fall, we promised to build you a sport palace, and we did. We created the ultimate in action entertainment, applauded by the national news media and racing fans everywhere. And now, continuing toward our goal of racing to be the best, we're spending over...
...1800s. 100 years later, there came the thoroughbred. Maryland Governor Ogle helped introduce thoroughbred racing to America. And for almost as many years as there has been a Maryland, there has been the horse. The wild ponies of Assateague. The state's official sport, jousting. And the breeding and racing of thoroughbreds, a billion-dollar part of Maryland's economy. Maryland, the free state, divided by the Chesapeake Bay, today comes together for the richest and most important day of racing in the state's history. Thoroughbred Sports and ESPN present live from Laurel Racecourse in Laurel, Maryland, the 1986 Maryland Million. Brought to you by First Jersey Securities, a nationwide investment firm. Come grow with us. By the Breeders' Cup, Thoroughbred Racing's $10 million day coming November 1st. The Thoroughbred record since 1875, the first word on thoroughbreds. By Del Rayo Estates, the ultimate winner's circle. ManaPro, the calf manna people. By the state of Maryland, more than you can imagine. Omni International Hotel, we put the more in Baltimore. And by Walmack International, winning the world over. And as we join you live at Laurel Racecourse in Laurel, Maryland, the horses have arrived in the paddock for the feature race on Maryland Million Day, the big $200,000 Budweiser Classic. And we welcome you to Maryland, everyone, as we come back to the second hour here, and there are the Budweiser Clydesdales as they make their appearance here. Budweiser very much in evidence, and one that Jim McKay, the originator of this Maryland Million idea, said was a real key for them to get this program off the ground. And hello again, everyone. Welcome back to Laurel Racecourse. For those joining us for this second hour, you missed a great first hour of racing. Had a lot of action for you. We're going to kind of recap that, look ahead for you a bit, too. The Maryland Million, again, is for the offspring of the nominated stallion standing in the state of Maryland. As we give you Dave Johnson and take a look at the race schedule ahead for this second hour.
Oh,
Dave?
Good racing coming up in this hour with the Budweiser Classic at a mile and a quarter for three-year-olds and up, and we'll be watching that live. And then on tape, we'll take a look at the Oaks run earlier this afternoon for three-year-old fillies at a mile and an eighth. Then the sprint, which is a handicap for three-year-olds and up at six furlongs. That's on tape. That's coming up. And then live, the ninth race on the program here, the Maryland handicap, a mile and an eighth, and that will be live. But what's happened so far in the previous hour? Well, here's the scoreboard. The USF&G Maryland Lassie winner was Smart Halo. The Maryland Nursery winner was First Patriot. The big horse from Woody's barn today was Glow. Maryland Turf winner, Cap It Off, Wire to Wire in the distaff, and Dismasted, the 1-5 shot, took the Maryland ladies.
And we're going to kind of bring you up to date now. Our co-feature was the Eskimo Pie ladies race on the... the turf here. We're going to take a look at the results of that for you and a look at the winner's circle. As you see, Mr. David P. Reynolds of Reynolds Metal and Mr. Fenton Hoard, the president of Eskimo Pie, making the presentation to our Eskimo Pie Maryland ladies winner, Dismasted. Owner Edward P. Evans, P.G. Johnson, the trainer Jean-Luc Samine in the yellow silks was the rider. Dave, let's take a look at the official order of finish now. The prices for the Eskimo Pie Maryland ladies.
Well, top to bottom, it was Dismasted home free with a joyful spray hanging on for the play spot. Etta Carine was third. Alden's Ambition, who had set the early pace, finished fourth in the mile in a 16th test on the turf. Turned to T.J., who made a move on the backstretch, ended up fifth. Lady Emerald was sixth. Martin's Choice, seventh. And Cheshire Kitten, who we thought had a bit of a shot, was absolutely last.
And they're in the paddock now for the Budweiser Classic, as you see them starting to move past our camera now. This is the big event on the card of nine. This is the one for $200,000. And giving an idea of some of the conditions of the race, it is for three-year-olds and up. They'll be going the classic American racing distance of a mile and a quarter on the main dirt track here. We will tell you that the three-year-olds will carry 126 pounds. And 121 pounds, you should say, the older horses will have 126. The horses are getting ready to come out on the track. We'll be back with the post-parade as we take a look again at our host city of Baltimore. We'll return to Laurel Race Course in a moment.
Subscribe to Europe's leading thoroughbred magazine, Pacemaker, an award-winning top-class reflection of European racing. A truly pleasurable way to stay informed on the many facets of thoroughbred performers. This magazine has distinctive style, both editorial and photographic. To subscribe, contact Ms. Heather Blair, our American representative in the offices of McLeod and Hopper. Pacemaker, like talking to a friend.
Hall of Fame trainer Jack Vanberg on horse nutrition and winning.
We've used calf manna for by Manapro for a long time now. We use it at our farm, on the babies, on the brood mares. And at each of our racing stables, we use it.
Here comes Gate Dancer.
Well, what I like about it the best, I think it keeps your flesh on your horses. And it's very strong. It's got the milk background in it. We love Cap Manna by Manapro because it does a great job for us and works for us.
Welcome back, just outside the city of Baltimore to Laurel, Maryland. And today is Maryland Million Day, and this is the big race. This, the Budweiser Maryland Classic. The horses are on the track, and let's take a look at the current odds. Brilliant Stepper, along with I Am the Game, the entry at 3-1. Epilogue is 12-1, and Due North at 16-1. Going down the field, Sparrow Vaughn is 2-1, Castellech 9-1, and the early favorite, and a bit of a question for this race, Harat at 6-5. There's a rundown of the odds for our big race today. The Budweiser Maryland Classic, $200,000 in the pot, $120,000 for first place. It is a mile and a quarter on the main dirt track. The horses are getting ready to make their turn, and Dave Johnson getting ready to bring us our post parade. You take a close look, pick your favorites out for this Budweiser Classic, Dave.
Okay, first of all, we start with Brilliant Stepper, who is number one, trained by King Leatherberry. This is a very consistent horse, but the weaker part of the entry from the Leatherberry barn. Been racing on the turf, but is at home on the dirt. Likes to run late, and a mile and a quarter just might be right up his alley. Donnie Miller rides. Number 1A is I Am the Game, certainly the stronger part of the entry. This horse actually did run in the Kentucky Derby in 85, was second to Spend a Buck on occasions. He's been best in 86 sprinting. He won the Rose Bend, and he's been second in his last two outs. That's I Am the Game, and that's Alberto Delgado in the pink and green colors. Epilogue with Greg McGarren is number two, and he's in front of the grandstand right now. Epilogue, it comes from the same barn as Broad Brush. That's Dickie Small's barn. Very, very many times to the post. 61 starts in his career, 27 times on the board, more than 20 times. This horse was a question mark at the distance this afternoon, though, and a question mark because he's jumping up in class. Due North is number three, Sparrow Vaughn number four, Castellet's the five horse, and Herat. The interesting thing here, Chris, is that the odds maker took the entry, Brilliant Stepper and I in the game, 8-5. The folks here have not responded. They've made Herat the 6-5 favorite. Sparrow Vaughn, who was second choice, who was actually third choice in the on the morning line, is second choice. And there is the favorite, Herat, who's been facing some of the best handicap horses around the country. And doing fairly well, picking up a lot of checks. He's earned over $651,000 in his career. The four-year-old by Northern Dancer, ridden this afternoon by Jerry Bailey, Herat.
And that's a rundown of the field for the Budweiser Maryland Classic. Again, for three and up, going a mile and a quarter. Tom Dawson did a little bit of handicapping for us here to take a closer look at our major contenders now for the Budweiser Maryland Classic. Before we get to that, quick look here, Brilliant Stepper, the bay colt, and a quick mention here, and Dave, a worth a mention, the trainer, King Leatherberry, truly one of the legends in our sport and one of the great folk heroes of Maryland when it comes to thoroughbreds.
How about a tip of the hat to Donnie Miller, who is the number one rider here at the current Laurel meet, and that's quite a combination of Leatherberry and Don Miller.
Well, I know Leatherberry is hoping that he will have a chance at this, Brilliant Stepper, but you mentioned the big half of the entry is I Am the Game. One of the horses that's our major contenders today, Tom Dawson takes a closer look at the Bud Classic contenders.
This is Herat, Eclipse Award-winning owner John Frank's four-year-old, known for his smallish size and a big heart. Speed is his game, and he's used it to compile over $650,000 in earnings against some of the very best in the country. Herat's ability to control the pace was never more evident than in the Grade 1 Santa Anita Handicap in March. After leading every step, Herat was still in front of champion Precisionist as the field turned into the stretch. The stretch-running threat, Greenton, in the red colors, loomed up on the outside as the field continued down the stretch with Herat in the lead. Soon, Greenton pulled alongside Herat, and the little one gave way very grudgingly in the run to the wire. The same speed and gameness shown here will make Herat very tough in the Classic. Game was also eligible to the Maryland Sprint, but trainer King Leatherberry preferred the smaller field and bigger purse of the Classic. I Am the Game has done his best work this year in sprints, including the Grade 3 Roseman Handicap at Belmont last June. Facing the capable Ziggy's Boy in today's sprint highweight King Swan, I Am the Game roared through a sloppy stretch to win in a time only 4/5 of a second off the track record. Last year's champion Maryland bred three-year-old stretches out today. Sparrow Vaughn is no stranger to top company, having won the Pennsylvania Derby last year. He appears to be coming to this race in good order, and his most recent start was really a smasher. Facing an allowance field at Pimlico, which included today's opponent, Due North, Sparrow Vaughn led at every pole and drew away from the field with comparative ease down the stretch, barely feeling the whip just once or twice. He went on to win by an impressive 9-length margin, and a repeat of that effort puts him right there in today's Budweiser Classic.
And there's a look at the gate, and they'll go a mile and a quarter here in the Budweiser Maryland Classic. When we return, there's one that should be easy to spot for you. Their own gelding, Castellet, will return to Laurel with more.
Strength. Pride. Tradition. For centuries, the Clydesdale has been known as a special breed. Today, the Clydesdale symbolize Budweiser's dedication to quality, superior ingredients, exclusive Beechwood aging, and a distinctively clean, crisp taste that only Budweiser can offer. Quality taste. Because this Bud's for you.
There's a familiar phrase among horsemen. Breed the best to the best. At Hermitage Farm, we take that seriously. That's why our stallions are among the world's finest. Raja Baba, sire of 50 stakes winners. Sauceboat, 9 stakes winners from his first 2 crumps. Plus Muttering, Hyperborean, Far Out East, and Northern Prospect. All outstanding sires. Warner L. Jones, Hermitage Farm, Goshen, Kentucky. Breeding winners for over 50 years.
This is the number of the ultimate winner's circle, a lifestyle dream you can make come true. This is Del Rio Estates at Rancho Santa Fe Farms, California, just north of San Diego. These luxury estate lots are measured in acres with a view that's priceless. The San Diego Valley offers a panorama of breathtaking beauty. From the famous Dwayne Lucas and Del Rio Racing Stables to three championship golf courses and beyond to a view of the Pacific. The number to call for Del Rio Downs. 65 luxury homes to be built in a totally secure development. 2 and 3 bedroom floor plans range in size from 2,500 to 4,000 square feet for those who appreciate the thoroughbred way of life. From the morning workouts to the time in the pastures to the racing at Del Mar and nearby Hollywood Park and Santa Anita. Make it a part of your lifestyle. Only at Del Rio Estates and Del Rio Downs, Rancho Santa Fe Farms, California. Write for this free brochure or call. Join us in the Ultimate Winner's Circle.
And the horses warming up behind the starting gate here at Laurel as we're going to take a look at our Budweiser long shot in the Budweiser Classic. Here's Dave Johnson.
Longshot is Castellettes. A roan gelding who at the age of 7 is the oldest horse in today's Budweiser Classic field. Castellettes has a strong late kick, as he showed here winning the Crusader Handicap on the grass. Watch the roan flying on the outside. He's the only member of today's field to have won at the mile and a quarter distance, and he has the services of jockey Alan Stacey, the nation's leading apprentice rider this year. Look for Castellettes with a strong late run at a good price. Today's Budweiser long shot.
And Castellettes on the board, the 5 horse at 9-1. Good price for our Budweiser long shot. And there he is, their own gelding. Dave, I'll tell you, just having Castellettes on the track is a story, as you also take a look up above at number 4, Sparrow Vaughn. But Castellettes has had problems.
He did. In fact, he was retired for a year. He did not race at age 3 at all, but has come back to the racing wars in fine fashion. And taking a look at Sparrow Vaughn, who was the winner of the Pennsylvania Derby as a 3-year-old last season, an interesting horse trained by Hank Allen, who used to play for the Washington Senators, and the brother of Richie Allen, who hit a lot of home runs in his career. So Hank Allen's trying to hit one this afternoon in the Budweiser Maryland Classic with a $200,000 purse, Sparrow Vaughn. Let's take a look at the final prices here as they get ready to load. Brilliant Stepper and I Am the Game, the 8-5 morning line choice. Maybe a bargain at 3-1. Epilogue is up to 21, as is Due North. Sparrow Vaughn, the 4 horse, is down to 2-1. Castellettes is at 9, and Harrit at even money.
Well, Tom Dawson, you gave us our major contenders. Why don't you give us another quick handicap here as they approach the gate, Tom?
It could look like 2 or 3 different races, Chris. A lot of speed from Harrit, possibly Sparrow Vaughn. Due North has a good deal of speed, and I Am the Game should be close. Brilliant Stepper and Castellettes will be nowhere close during the early going. If there's any late running to be done, it should come from one of those two.
Take a look at the track record here now for the mile and a quarter. One Sunday way back in 1969. They don't run many mile and a quarter races here. The record could fall. Dave, interesting story by Harrit, dug up by Jamie Saltz, one of our outstanding production people.
As a matter of fact, I even ran into John Franks as he was making his way through the crowd. It seems that Harrit stepped on a nail and they had to pull the nail out of his hoof, so he was a question mark until today, but he is apparently in great shape. He's even money, and let's go to the top of the stands for the call of the Budweiser Maryland Classic with a $200,000 purse. Here's track announcer Robin Byrne.
Thanks a lot, Dave. We've got one more to go in. That'll be I Am the Game. And we're just about ready here for the Budweiser Maryland Classic. And they're off in the Budweiser Maryland Classic. Harrit between horses is going to the front. I Am the Game moving up on the outside. Second, Due North is third. Sparrow Vaughn quickly between horses fourth. Castellettes is next. Epilogue and Brilliant Stepper past the stands the first time as they race to the clubhouse turn. Harrit snugly on the rail, has the lead by a length and a half. I Am the Game on the outside is second, 3/4 of a length. Sparrow Vaughn is third, gap of 2. Due North is fourth, followed by the gray horse Castellettes. Next in line is Epilogue, and yet to get on track in the early going is Brilliant Stepper. They straighten out for their long run down the backstretch, and Harrit, the even money favorite, bounces along on a 2-length lead. I Am the Game on the outside is second by a nose. Red alongside in third, Spirovan. Due North follows in fourth. Castellets, Epilogue, and Brilliant Stepper. The quarter in 23-3, the half in 47-4, continuing down the backstretch. Herat continues to go easily on the front end. He leads by four lengths. Spiro Van is now second by a length and a half. I Am the Game dropping back in the third. Due North is now closing up on the rail, followed by Castellets, Epilogue, and Brilliant Stepper. Three quarters in 1:12-1. They move around the far turn, and Herat continues to lead by two. Moving up on the outside, second, Spirovan, gaining along the rail, Due North with Castellets coming quickly. That's all for I Am the Game. Brilliant Steppers coming quick along the rail, and Epilogue. The mile in 38-1. The real running starts now at the top of the stretch as Herat, trying to make every pole when he won, continues to show the way. Herat, Castellets, and Allen Stacy are now under a full head of steam on the far outside with Due North on the rail third. They've got their work cut out for them now because Jerry Bailey is taking Herat coast to coast. Easy winner, number six, Herat, wire to wire for Jerry Bailey. Five, Castellets second, three, Due North third. The running time here, 1/5 off the track record, 2:03 1/5.
Well, they're cheering at Winfield's, the little son of Northern Dancer, Herat, the one that we saw that chased them all and made him try to catch him at the big cap at Santa Anita when we started this year off. They caught him there, but they weren't going to catch him today. Herat, a fifth of a second off the track record that, remember, dated back to 1969. They're celebrating in Louisiana, too. The Eclipse Award-winning owner has won it with Herat. We'll be back with the classic results.
This bug's for all that you do.
I'd like to help you. I just don't have the time.
Bob, I need a trainer.
How about Eddie?
He's just a kid.
So was I.
Hey, Eddie!
You worked long and hard to get there. When the time comes, you hope you're ready.
Son, I'm counting on you.
For that clean, crisp taste that makes Budweiser the king of beers.
You're doing great.
Thanks.
Who's talking to you?
This bud's for you.
Claiborne at Keeneland, November breeding stock sale. This year featuring several outstanding prospects, including the brilliant race mare Heatherton, winner of seven graded stakes and over $1 million, in foal to leading sire Danzig. The Claiborne consignment features brood mares in foal to Nijinsky 2, Sir Ivor, Secretariat, Forley, Believe It, and many more. Claiborne Farm, selling in November at Keeneland.
Who says America has run out of opportunities?
There are plenty out there, if you look for them. The people who built this country were doers, not doubters. Risk takers, seeking opportunities, not guarantees. Today, I still see vast opportunities in hundreds of small to mid-sized companies whose entrepreneurial spirit and energy will continue to build America. At First Jersey Securities, we specialize in discovering such emerging growth companies for today's investors with vision. First Jersey Securities, come grow with us.
There he is, the son of Northern Dancer, the bay colt Herat, owned by John Franks of Shreveport, Louisiana, a two-time Eclipse Award-winning owner. Saw Mr. Franks earlier today. He is just barely in the lead, he said, for that award this year. This didn't hurt him any. Jerry Bailey is the rider, and Dave Johnson, Jerry did quite a job today.
Third winner of the afternoon for Mr. Bailey, the 29-year-old native of Dallas, Texas. And they're waiting for the folks to come to the winner's circle so they can have their picture taken with Herat. Let's watch the stretch drive. It was a wire-to-wire, coast-to-coast, as Robin called it, victory into the stretch. And I'm going to ask Jerry if he knew how fast he was going. He really shakes up the Northern Dancer colt here. And Castellets, our Bud Longshot, makes a game effort coming from the back of the pack to grab the second spot. Due North holds for third, but the margin of victory is a long one, about seven or eight lengths. And Herat is the easiest kind of winner here this afternoon in the Budweiser Classic.
The colors of John Franks are on Jerry Bailey's back. He's going to get ready to head to the winner's circle. When we come back, we'll have some winners' interviews and take a look at the official numbers as Her Rat, the Bay Colpa Northern Dancer, is the winner of our Budweiser Maryland Classic. We'll be back in a moment.
Thoroughbred horses account for fortunes won and fortunes bid, for records broken and odds beaten. One thing that makes this sport count for me is the money it can generate in the pocket of the $2 bettor or the $1 million investor. But there's a romance to it too. Powerful horses and strong-willed people, contests of might and endurance and intelligence. The Thoroughbred Record covers it all beautifully. Each month, the Thoroughbred Record brings you all the color and excitement of racing, along with insight into the business of thoroughbreds, the bloodlines and statistics that have made horsemen count on the Thoroughbred Record since 1875. This will count for you, just $34.95 for a 12-month subscription, a full 50% off the cover price. Call 1-800-247-2160 and receive free the Sire Book, a $25 value. 1-800-247-2160. If thoroughbred horses count to you, you can count on the Thoroughbred Record.
Well, they're waiting for Jerry Bailey to weigh in. He's done that. He's popped up here to talk to Dave Johnson. They're going to make the prices official as the Budweiser folks with the beautiful Waterford Crystal making the presentations to owner John Franks, trainer Jack Van Berg. Mike Rorty, the executive vice president of Anheuser-Busch and their director of marketing, is here as a lot of the Budweiser folks nationally and regionally are here today as part of Maryland Million. There's Jack Van Berg with the red coat, and he's about to put a Bud hat on, too. Let's go now to Dave Johnson. Dave Johnson has the winning rider.
Jerry, had you ridden this horse before?
I don't believe so. I ran with him when he was a very young horse with Woody Stevens had him, but I'd never ridden him.
Did you know how fast you were going? Only a fifth off the track record?
Well, I knew he had an easy first quarter, but from then on, he did nothing but run.
Well, let's watch that first quarter, because that was really important, wasn't it, the start?
Yes, it was. You know, I was concerned about at least the first quarter of a mile if they didn't push him too hard, because he is a little tiny thing, and he carried 126 pounds. But he just all run. He's not very big, but he's all run.
What'd Jack tell you, to get out in front and hold it?
He said open up a couple and take a long hold, slow it down as best you can, and give him a breather around the turn, and then just when you turn over home, go with him.
Special thanks to Budweiser. Never in doubt.
At the half a mile pole, I knew he was a winner.
Let's watch the stretch drive, and Jerry, I know that you've got a mount in the ninth race, so we won't keep you much longer, but turning for home, you shook him up.
I hit him a couple times just to see how he'd open up. He did, and I hand-rode him to the wire. But he was just full of run.
Well, congratulations. You like Maryland, by the way?
It's been good to me today, Dave.
Okay.
Thanks.
Congratulations. Jerry Bailey, who rode Herat to win the Budweiser Classic. And he'll be back to try and make it four.
And let's take a look at the prices now. They have made it official as Jerry Bailey weighed in and Herat doing the mile and a quarter in 2:03 1/5, 4:03 2:40, Castellets, $6.80 and $4, and Due North, $4.20. And who's that in the Budweiser hat? Jim McKay, our host of the day, has got the King of Beers hat on. Let's take a complete look at the order of finish now in the $200,000 feature race here, the Budweiser Classic. Here is the full run through of horses. Herat finishing first. Castellets, our Budweiser long shot. Not bad, Dave Johnson getting the show of place price there. And then Due North, Brilliant Stepper was fourth. Rounding out the field, Sparrow Vaughn was fifth. Epilogue was six, and I Am the Game finished seven. There's the complete rundown of the field for the Budweiser Maryland Classic. More racing action coming from Laurel when we return.
We blend lessons from the past with the latest technology to make Lane's End in Versailles, Kentucky, the ultimate thoroughbred farm. Horses and humans alike enjoy the ambience at Lane's End, but that's not why we do it. The Lane's End Thoroughbred Breeding and Development Program, begun more than 25 years ago, has earned the respect of knowledgeable professionals the world over, but that's not why we do it. The Lane's End Stallion roster includes champions such as Kentucky Derby winner Spendabuck and proven sires such as Sovereign Dancer. It is a pleasure to stand such fine thoroughbreds, but that's not why we do it. We do it to win.
Announcing the Valvoline 4Guard I Love a Parade sweepstakes. Win a trip for four to four of America's greatest parades. To enter, watch the next commercial and remember what the driver of the smoking car says. Then go to a participating store for details.
Big parade this year.
It's the economy.
Oh, Russell, what kind of motor oil are you using?
Motor oil
definitely is not motor oil. A four-cylinder engine works harder and needs the extra protection of specially formulated Valvoline 4Guard.
Not much of a parade this year.
It's the economy.
Oh, Russell!
Omni Hotels, serving the great cities of America, are known for their distinctive service and distinguished style. And the Omni International Baltimore is no exception. Located in the heart of the financial district, only four blocks from the famed Harbor Place and National Aquarium, we're ready to serve you with 714 handsome guest rooms and a variety of affordable weekend packages and group rates. For reservations in Baltimore and other fine Omni hotels coast to coast, call 1-800-THE-OMNI.
Welcome back to Maryland Million Day here at Laurel Race Course, and we've just wrapped up the Budweiser Classic for you. We're going to take you back earlier in the day now to our fourth race of the afternoon. It's the Omni International Hotel Maryland Oaks, $100,000 the purse. It's for three-year-old fillies going a mile and an eighth. And Dave, let's take a look at the ladies who are going to race.
And a field of eight, including the entry from the King Leatherberry Barn, of Fancy Feathers with Greg Hutton, and Notch's Trace with Mario Pino, and the closing price was 3.5 to 1. Azerbaijani with Wayne Barnett at 18. Weak Moonquake, trained by Ron Alfano, who's the leading rider here, in the irons. Smart and Quick was the 4-to-5 favorite with Alberto Delgado. Sunset Gun at 16 with Bill Daniels. My Mafalda, who won her last wire-to-wire with Greg McCarron at 9-2. And Miss Rudy T, who is coming off two straight victories with Carlos Barrera, starting from the outside. That's the field. Phillies, three-year-olds in action. International Maryland Oaks. Robin?
They're off. Miss Rudy T with My Mafalda quickly between fillies. Azerbaijani. Long Rail is into third. Notch's Trace is fourth. Long Rail, Spartan Quick is fifth. Sunset Gun on the outside, followed by Weak Moonwalk and Fancy Feather. Round the clubhouse turn. The speed filly has command of it by two lengths. My Mafalda. Long Rail, Azerbaijani is second by a length and a half. Ranging up on the outside, Miss Rudy T is third. With the leaders in fourth, Notch's Trace, Sunset Gun, Spartan Quick, Weak Moonwalk, and Fancy Feather. Quarter and 23-1 there, down the backstretch. My Mafalda leads by about a length and a half. Part of the entry is in the second, Notch's Trace. Azerbaijani is right alongside in third. Gap of a length and a half, Miss Rudy T is fourth. The gray filly starts up along the rail. Spartan Quick on the outside, Sunset Gun, Weak Moonwalk, and Fancy Feather. The half is a lively 46-4 as My Mafalda sets a realistic pace. My Mafalda has been joined by Notch's Trace on the outside, second. These two are now matching strides for the lead. Here comes Alberto Delgado and the favorite, Spartan Quick, rushing up on the far outside. They move to the top of the stretch. Spartan Quick comes on to challenge My Mafalda for the lead. Notch's Trace is dropping back into third. Miss Rudy T, Azerbaijani, Sunset Gun, Weak Moonwalk, and Fancy Feathers there into the stretch. Spartan Quick has the lead by a length and a half. Miss Rudy T on the outside is now coming relentlessly. Spartan Quick is now fighting to stay there. Miss Rudy T on the outside is looking her right in the eye. We've got a dandy here in the Omni. These two boys to the wire. Oh, real tight in here.
And a close photo finish it was, but the photo revealed the favorite, number four, Smart and Quick, was the winner under Alberto Delgado, with number seven, Miss Rudy T, second, and number six, My Mafalda, finishing third. And the trainer of the good filly Smart and Quick is Katie Voss, who is also the president of the Maryland Horse Breeders Association. And Katie, this has to be a real thrill, your organization's involvement with the Maryland Million, and then winning one of the races today.
This really was. It's the biggest thrill I've ever had in racing.
When we were watching the race at the head of the stretch, I thought you might get away with it. this one pretty easily when your filly took a big lead.
I heaved a sigh of relief at the head of the stretch. I figured we were all set, and at the eighth pole, I saw the other filly coming. It scared me to death. They took too long to put up the photo for me.
Did you think that she might have trouble holding on at this point?
The other filly looked like she could get to her, but she managed to hang on.
And hang on she did to win the Omni International Maryland Oaks. Katie, congratulations on everything that has to do with this Maryland Million Day, including your win.
Thank you, Tom. This sure does make it a big day.
Official results of the Omni International Maryland Oaks was Smart and Quick, the favorite, the winner, 380, 260, and 220. Miss Rudy T, a close second, 380 and 280. Maya Mafalda, the pace setter, finished third for 320.
And the presentation, Mr. Henry Knott, the owner of Omni International, Mr. Robert James, managing director of Omni International. That wraps the International Maryland Oaks. But still more on our story, the Bud Classic. Let's go to Tom Dawson.
Refocusing again on the Budweiser Classic for just a moment with trainer Jack Van Berg of Herat. Jack, a little scare before the race the other day.
Well, they called me yesterday morning. Chris always calls me 2:45 California time. It's 5:45 here. And he said, I checked his legs. He said everything was perfect. So I had another call from Kentucky. And when I got off that call, he was on back on the phone. He said, Jack, this horse can't put his foot down.
What did you discover?
Well, he'd been playing, had to play the night before, and sprung his shoe and had a nail rubbing the wall of it. And I figured, because he had done it once before in California. So I told him what to do, and Jack Ballinger, the blacksmith, has shot for me for years in Boston around here. I had him call him. I have Jack's number, and Jack came down and took the rest of the shoe off, and they went to soaking it and policing it. And I got in here last night at midnight, and Jack was waiting on me, and we worked on him last night, and we put the shoe back on this morning, and he was perfect.
Sure was. He ran a heck of a race back to his old form he showed last spring.
He ran an awful big race in California going the mile and a quarter. He ran two big races with Precisionists over there at Hollywood Park, you know, when they hooked up head and head. But this horse going a mile and a quarter, a mile and a half, he loves it. He can just sit there and relax and run his own game.
And he did it today, and we hope to see him do it again. Jack Van Berg, trainer of Herat, winner of the Budweiser Classic.
Thank you, Tom. Underlining the class of this event, the people it attracts, including Mr. Michael J. Rorty, the Executive Vice President, Director of Marketing, Anheuser-Busch, presenting the beautiful Waterford Crystal for the Budweiser Maryland Million, our feature race to Herat, the son of Northern Dancer. As you see, the horses in the paddock. Oh, yes, more racing coming up. And then a Breeders' Cup update when we return.
If you just ask for a light beer,
give me a light.
You never know what you'll get.
Bugs. No, actually, Bud Light.
So if you want the less filling light beer with the first name and taste, ask for Bud Light.
Yours?
No. As everything else.
Give me a light.
Showtime.
It's just a light.
Desire. The desire to win. It's something you're born with. In the blood of every great competitor, you'll find a burning desire for victory. Reaching farther, going faster, Walmart International. Winning the world over.
Chiefs crowd is surging. Gate Dancer is closing boldly on the outside. Proud Truth, he was last down the backstretch. He's taking it to the leader. It's Gate Dancer in front. Proud Truth is right at his lip. Proud Truth on the outside. Gate Dancer is game. Proud Truth ahead. Gate Dancer goes to a driving finish. Proud Truth has won it.
See seven championship races for $10 million on Breeders' Cup Day, Saturday, November 1st.
Omni Hotels, serving the great cities of America, are known for their distinctive service and distinguished style. And the Omni International Baltimore is no exception. Located in the heart of the financial district, only four blocks from the famed Harbor Place and National Aquarium, we're ready to serve you with 714 handsome guest rooms and a variety of affordable weekend packages and group rates. For reservations in Baltimore and other fine Omni hotels coast to coast, call 1-800-THE-OMNI.
And we're happy to present to you our Breeders' Cup update on Maryland Million Day. And you know, the Maryland Million Day, of course, was inspired by the Breeders' Cup. Breeders' Cup Day number one, 1984. And Jim McKay, coming back on an airplane, said, why can't we have a day like that in Maryland? And that's just what they've done. The folks at Breeders' Cup, of course, are getting ready for Breeders' Cup 3 at beautiful Santa Anita Racecourse. And with that in mind, let's take a look at the point standings now, the latest point standings, as we take a look at the leaders going into Breeders' Cup Day on November 1st. And we start with the three-year-old and older males headed by Precisionist. And, of course, he just won at Santa Anita under new rider Gary Stevens. Ruard, Broadbrush, Creme Fraiche all meet tonight in the Great Meadowlands Cup at the Meadowlands Racecourse. Danza Connection, 24 points. That, of course, our Belmont winner. And what can you say about the lady? It was her day at Belmont Park today. She was honored. Lady Secret just running away with this division. Three-year-old enough, fillies and mares. Lady Secret with 60 points. Life at the top next with 35. Then as we go to the point leaders in the turf category, Estrapod, winning last Sunday's Oak Tree Invitational, winner of the Arlington Million, leads the way in the division. Glow, of course, a winner here in the Maryland Million in the point standings. Love That Mac, leading over Phone Trick. Phone Trick has been retired now because of an injury. Groovy, meanwhile, won the ancient title handicap. That's a rundown of the top sprinters in the Breeders' Cup point standings. And Gulch leads the way for the two-year-olds. Maybe a shakeup in those standings. We'll have a chance to tell you more about that in a moment. Gulch bet twice, Conquista Rose jazzing around and persevered. And the two-year-old fillies, Sakawista. Who else but a D-Wayne Lucas filly would be on top there? Delicate Vine, the R tells you she has been retired because of an injury. And some late news from Belmont Park. Steve Nagler, our producer, on the phone with the folks there to find out the information on the Champagne Stakes, the 115th running of this mile race, one of the outstanding tests for two-year-olds of the year. And the results from Belmont Park. Polish Navy wins the mile in 1:35.1, and Bet Twice finished third. Bet Twice third. Polish Navy's going to move up on those Breeders' Cup point list. All right, let's take a look now at our next race here in the Maryland Million. We're going to take you back a bit earlier today to the First National Bank of Maryland, their Maryland Sprint Handicap. $100,000, six furlongs. It's for three-year-olds and up going the sprint. And Dave Johnson's going to take a look at the field for the First National Bank Maryland Handicap.
We start with number one, Color Me Smart, who is shipped down from Canada and is at 6-1 with Don Seymour. Jerry Bailey had them out on safe at second at 25. Count the Dots with Alan Stacey, 30-1. April Sun was the four, smarting up 7-1 with Donnie Miller. Bear Down, a long shot at 60 with Danny Wright, and King Swan was the 1-5 favorite. Hope Me Die was 60, War Campaign 24, and Cool Joe completed the field with Jean-Luc Samin. All in line, 3/4 of a mile. The handicap for three-year-olds and up. It was the $100,000 purse. The Maryland sprint handicap. A little bit of trouble in the gate. Now we're all set. Here's Robin's call of the sprint.
They're off. Way to a good start quickly on the rail. Color Me Smart takes the lead. Moving up on the outside, second, Bear Down. Safe on second, along the rail is third. Between horses, smarting up is fourth. Cool Joe on the outside is fifth. King Swan between horses, sixth. War Campaign is seventh on the far outside. Hope Me Die is next. Count the Dots and April Sun. They sprint by the opening quarter in 22-4, continuing down the backstretch. Up on the outside, safe on second, pokes ahead in front. Color Me Smart along the rail is second, Bear Down is third. Cool Joe on the outside is fourth, gap of two to smarten up. The favorite better get on track, now he's got a long way to come, King Swan. Along the rail, Count the Dots, ranging up on the outside, War Campaign, followed by April Sun and Hope Me Die. The half in 46-2, they're turning into the stretch, and three horses are vying for command. The Canadian Vader gains along the rail, poke ahead in front, Color Me Smart. Safe on second between horses. Cool Joe on the outside, and here comes the champ, King Swan on the outside. Can he make it? Three horses are still going at it. King Swan couldn't get it off, and he does. Seven, what an effort. King Swan wins it. Ted Cool Joe, second, one, smarten up, third. Very, very tight on a quick 1-11 over this tiring oval.
A 2-5 shot, having to work very hard to get there. King Swan gets up in the final strides to win the First National Bank of Maryland sprint. At the top of the stretch, King Swan in some kind of trouble. There he is on the outside. Meanwhile, along the rail, it was Color Me Smart with the lead. Right next door, Safe on second, and Cool Joe making a race of it as they come to the wire. On the inside, Color Me Smart, you see, with the lead. Between horses, Safe on second, Cool Joe, and it doesn't look like King Swan's going to get there. But under a strong ride from Jimbo Bracelli, he gets up on the outside under the left-handed whip and nails the pace setters right at the wire to take the victory here in the first National Bank of Maryland Sprint Handicap. A tough job for the 2-5 favorite King Swan, but he does get the job done. He pays 260, 240, and 210. Cool Joe, 560 and 210. Color Me Start returns 210 to show, running time of 1:11 flat for the 6 furlongs.
Thank you much, Tom. Making the presentation for the First National Bank of Maryland, the Sprint Handicap, President, Chief Executive Officer of First National, Mr. Charles W. Cole, as King Swan wins the First National Bank of Maryland Sprint. We'll be returning to Laurel Racecourse for, that's right, more racing.
Silverbuck was one of the outstanding handicap performers of his generation, winning over $400,000, including victories in Grade 1 stakes like the Whitney Handicap and his track record performance in the Suburban Handicap. Silverbuck's first crop of 54 two-year-olds are racing in 1986, and his very first starter, Bowl of Flowers, just won the Tampa Bay Derby Juvenile Stakes Fillies Division. Silverbuck at Happy Valley Farm. Brilliant on the racetrack and off to a brilliant start as a sire.
The new era in Kentucky racing is underway at Turfway Park, formerly Latonia in Florence, Kentucky, just south of Cincinnati. The initial stages of an $11 million renovation has already begun with a new tone and message center board and a bigger, safer racetrack at Turfway. Horsemen, be watching the Thoroughbred publications for nomination news to the richest guaranteed purse in Kentucky racing history. The March 29th Jim Beam Stakes has been increased to $500,000. It's new and getting better. Come race with us into the future at Turfway Park.
Thoroughbred horses account for fortunes won and fortunes bid, for records broken and odds beaten. One thing that makes this sport count for me is the money it can generate in the pocket of the $2 bettor or the $1 million investor. But there's a romance to it too, powerful horses and strong-willed people, contests of might and endurance and intelligence. The Thoroughbred Record covers it all beautifully. Each month, the Thoroughbred Record brings you all the color and excitement of racing, along with insight into the business of thoroughbreds, the bloodlines and statistics that have made horsemen count on the Thoroughbred Record since 1875. This will count for you, just $34.95 for a 12-month subscription, a full 50% off the cover price. Call 1-800-247-2160 and receive free the Sire Book, a $25 value. 1-800-247-2160. If Thoroughbred horses count to you, you can count on the Thoroughbred Record.
Well, the shadow's getting longer. The sun's starting to slip towards the horizon now as we near 6 o'clock and towards the end of our big day here, the Maryland Million Day of Racing. And what a special event we have coming up for you to wind things up. The Thoroughbred ARC-sponsored Maryland Starter Handicap. These are for three-year-olds and up, which have started for a claiming price of $15,000 or less this year. That's right, claimers with a chance at a $50,000 purse and to participate in Maryland Million Days. Certainly the claiming horse, the backbone, Dave, of any racing program.
And an interesting field with some great stories. Let's take a look at the field in post position order. We have Afton on top at 2-1 right now with Alan Stacey. Bare Feet with Paul Nicole at 6. Vandy's Friend with Greg McCarron at 12. Tufton, ridden by Donnie Miller, 5-1. Whitechapel Willie with Tom Kupfer is up to 15. Uncle Bentley with Danny Need is at 17. Dansk Mask with Jerry Bailey trying for his fourth winner of the day, 3-1. And favorites certainly have done well here this afternoon. Coppolo with Carlos Barrera at 19. Off the Vine with Mario Pino at 35. And London Market with Frank Lovato Jr. at 8-1. You know, Jim McKay had a dream, but a man by the name of Roy Lerman, who was a practicing attorney here in Baltimore, had a dream too. He dreamed about the racetrack and dreamed how great it would be to be a trainer. Well, he gave up the practice and he turned to training. He has a small stable, but he has some winners, and he's got the 3-1 favorite in here, and he's got Jerry Bailey riding his horse, Dance Mask. But a couple of the other competitors in here look to stop Dance Mask, Afton and Tufton and London Market. In fact, the 10 horse, London Market, who is at 8-1 right now, started at 15, was shipped down by trainer Howie Tesher to test the likes of Dance Mask this afternoon in this mile and an eighth contest. And as we said, Tufton and Afton also getting some support.
Well, the horse approaching the starting gate, and Tom Dawson, you've taken a look as well at this Thoroughbred Arc Maryland handicap, and it just amazed me again. A claiming horse going for 50,000 time, they've got to be thrilled to be in this race.
Absolutely, Chris, and you know, some people, I believe, got eligible for starter races just so they could be in this race, and I think the eight-horse Cupola is probably a good example of that. There's Afton, he is the favorite right now, claimed for $25,000, so he's one of those that went through the claiming ranks, got claimed, got eligible for the starter races, and here he is in there today. But Cupola was dropped down to get eligible. He had a mile prep last week. He's a nice price at 22-1, and if we had a long shot in this race, I think he'd be mine.
And the one horse Afton going in now, as you take a look from up above here at the starting gate, up for the final time here, and again the distance is 1 mile and one furlong, a mile and an eighth here as they'll go around the $50,000 Thoroughbred Arc Maryland handicap, $10,000 first prize. There loading in was the three, Vandy's Friend, and coming in now, number four with the yellow silks, that is Tufton, ridden by Don Miller. Dave?
I'll be anxious to see how Uncle Bentley does. Here's a horse who's been running exclusively on the turf, this five-year-old gelding. It'd be easy to follow. He's the gray that just moved into line, purple and rose sash there. Now he's trying the dirt, and I guess with $50,000 at stake, I would be putting him in here too.
I wonder how many of these might, after this dream, return to the claiming ranks.
Well, they're all going to return to the claiming ranks because this is probably the only time in their life they're going to be going for $50,000.
Tom Dawson's long shot, Cupola, just went in. That was the eight horse he was talking about that is now at 22-1. Robin Burns, he's had quite a day. Let's hear your final call for this Maryland handicap.
Thanks very much, Chris. One more to go in, London Market. They're all in line. They're off. Thoroughbred Arc Maryland handicap, bare feet breaking slowly. Early speed along the rail belongs to Afton, Tufted on the outside. Vandy's Friend is in between horses, far outside, Cupola to fourth. Dance Mask gains between horses, fifth, the gray horses, next Uncle Bentley. Bare feet is back into contention, White Chapel Willie. And the trailers, ninth and tenth, are off the vine in London Market. A real speed duel as they are hooked up on the front end, straightening out for their long run down the backstretch. Vandy's Friend on the outside, Afton on the rail. These two are really going at it. The quarter in 23 and 2, they've got about six lengths on the rest of the field. Afton, nearest the rail, has the lead by a nose. Vandy's Friend is right alongside in second. Tufton picks up the chase, third, Cupola is fourth. Dance Mask between horses, followed by Uncle Bentley. Bare feet on the outside, Whitechapel Willie, London Market, and off the vine. The half is a realistic 46-2. They're past the half mile pole. Afton and Alan Stacy, Greg McKiernan, and Vandy's Friend are still going at it. Vandy's Friend on the outside gets the best of Afton. Vandy's Friend now in front by two lengths. Afton is dropping back in the second. Cupola moving up on the outside, third, Tufton between horses. Bare feet, London Market, Dance Mask in the center, followed by Uncle Bentley along the rail, off the vine and Whitechapel Willie. Three quarters in 1:12 and two, they're into the stretch. Vandy's Friend has been joined by Tufton on the outside. Cupola now looming boldly in mid-stretch. London Market on the far outside. They're inside the final eighth of a mile. Vandy's Friend going the race of his life is strong on top. Tufton on the outside is second. On the far outside, London Market in a driving finish. Very, very tight. We're going to call number 10, London Market, by a nose. Number 4, Tufton was second. Very, very close for third. The running time here, 1:54 and 1/5.
Oh, what a great way to end Maryland Million Day. Those claimers fighting their heart out to the wire as the photo sign goes up. And it's going to take a close photo to separate them. The claimers in the spotlight, and they ran like champions today. We'll be back in just a moment to wrap up our final race on Maryland Million Day.
Give me a light. Bud Light.
If you just ask for a light beer, you never know what you'll get.
A pitcher of light.
Bud Light.
So if you want the less filling light beer with the first name and taste, Don't just ask for a light beer.
Give me a light.
Ask them to bring out their best.
Bud Light.
Bud Light. Because everything else is just a light.
A dream is born. And with care and attention, discipline and freedom, the dream begins to come alive. Share the dream. Let thoroughbred racing come alive for you.
Who says America has run out of opportunities?
There are plenty out there, if you look for them. The people who built this country were doers, not doubters. Risk takers, seeking opportunities, not guarantees. Today, I still see vast opportunities in hundreds of small to mid-sized companies whose entrepreneurial spirit and energy will continue to build America. At First Jersey Securities, we specialize in discovering such emerging growth companies for today's investors with vision. First Jersey Securities, come grow with us.
Cheshire Kitten has a 5-length lead. Yatani is second with some Jersey.
Thoroughbred racing. It can be more than just a spectator sport. The experienced and successful management team of Thoroughbred American Racing Consultants, Thoroughbred ARC, are ready to make you a participant and owner. Thoroughbred ARC brings together the best horses and the best horsemen to get you into the winner's circle. Racing and selling thoroughbreds for profit. Find out how you can win in the sport of kings with Thoroughbred ARC.
It's still up. The photo sign is still there, trying to decide the Thoroughbred ARC Maryland Starter Handicap for the claimers, those that have run for $15,000 or less this year. But today had a chance to live a big dream, to run in a $50,000 race with a $10,000 first prize, and it was a great race. There you see him circling, waiting. Could it be Tufted to number 4? He thought maybe he was there. Maybe number 10, London Market, he was close. We're waiting to see. Jeff Wiseman, publicity director here at Laurel, just gave me some news. 20,103 here at Laurel, jamming in today for the first Maryland Million Day, betting near $3 million. Both riders are still up, Dave, as they're awaiting, and these are tense moments.
And it must be very tense for Frank Lovato Jr. He was named to ride Grand Roll, who would have been odds on in the second race. Shipped down here from New York only to find that Grand Roll was scratched this afternoon. He picks up the mount on a 9-1 shot, and I'm sure that he's hoping that this afternoon's day will turn sunny for him after at 6 o'clock in the Maryland sunshine.
And of course, on number 4, there is Don Miller, the perennial king here of Maryland racing, as he circles. And they kind of just casually glance at the board. They don't want to seem too anxious. They're still waiting. The crowd's waiting. And it's gotten much quieter here all of a sudden. These are for the claimers, remember now. This is the last race of Maryland Million Day, ninth race on the program, the Thoroughbred ARC Maryland Handicap. Well, getting off first is Frank Lovato Jr., London Market. Well, we still don't know. We're going to take a break, take a breath, and see if we can take a closer look at this photo. When we come back, we will have the results of the Thoroughbred ARC Maryland Handicap. Photo sign still up.
Cheshire Kitten has a 5-length lead. Natani is second with some jersey.
Thoroughbred racing. It can be more than just a spectator sport. The experienced and successful management team of Thoroughbred American Racing Consultants, Thoroughbred ARC, are ready to make you a participant and owner. Thoroughbred ARC brings together the best horses and the best horsemen to get you into the winner's circle. Racing and selling thoroughbreds for profit. Find out how you can win in the sport of kings with Thoroughbred ARC.
Imagine Virginia's beaches. Imagine Florida's sun. Imagine New York nightlife. Massachusetts history. West Virginia's hills. Now, imagine a vacation that offers all this and more within one state. Because while you are imagining these wonderful places, you are actually seeing Maryland. There's more to Maryland than you can imagine.
The laughter of children, the warmth of holidays, the serenity of still autumn mornings, a place to rest and dream and grow, to be secure. The people of Ryland understand what makes a house a home. That understanding strengthens our commitment to build homes of quality, value, and integrity. Rylan builds beautiful, affordable homes in lovely communities all across America. For the Rylan community nearest you, see your local paper. Rylan homes are built for life.
They're still circling. The photo sign is still up. The fans are still waiting. They're not going to let him go home, Dave Johnson here. And I don't know, I'm starting to suspect maybe a dead heat.
Well, I'm sure Bill Fisher is one of the placing judges upstairs, got the magnifying glass out. Maybe they'll call in Judge Wapner. Who knows? But usually when it takes this long, they are making absolutely certain. And many, many times it turns out to be a dead heater.
Tom Dawson, any thoughts from over on you? You're closer to the finish line.
I'm closer, but I don't think I'm any closer to coming up with a winner, Chris. One of the interesting points here, I think, is that the two horses in the photo, one is a three-year-old, Tufton, the other a four-year-old, London Market. In these starter races, we used to see a lot of seven- and eight-year-olds. Now a lot of younger horses getting eligible for these kind of races, partly because, of course, in this case, the big money, but just in general, more young horses running in these starter races, and I think that's very good for the sport.
We're still waiting. We're going to hang on here to try to get this official. For you. I'm going to give you a quick rundown real quickly of the Maryland Lassie Smart Halo won that our first race of the day. The Maryland Nursery First Patriot Glow won in an impressive fashion the Maryland Turf. The Maryland Oaks Smart and Quick won that. King Swan won the Maryland Sprint Handicap. Cap It Off took the Maryland Distaff Handicap. Dismasted, our co-feature, the $150,000 Maryland Ladies. The Budweiser Classic was won in great fashion by Herat. And the ninth race winner, we don't know.
Well, one thing we can say is that it's going to be the biggest price of the day because it's really been a day for favorites here and many of the mods on. But the four horse, that was Tufton, went off at 4.5-1, and London Market went off at a big 9-1.
Again, the photo sign still glowing here as it gets a little bit darker in Baltimore. Want to remind you that next year we will be back here for the Maryland Million, back in Maryland, but it will move to the historic Pimlico Racecourse, September 26th. And coming up November 15th, Dave, we'll be right back here for one of the great turf races of the year, the Washington, D.C. International, and a couple of our horses are expected to be in the Washington, D.C. International November 15th.
Well, I wouldn't be at all surprised to see Herat and Glow in that one.
That's right. I think Dismasted also is a possibility to be involved with us in the Washington, D.C. International. Again, that is November 15th. So many people to thank. I know Jim McKay, they had a special presentation for him to thank him. And there's Frank Lovato. He is still staring out at that tote board, waiting to see if 10 comes up. That's his horse, London Market. But Jim McKay, a special presentation made to him, Dave. A thank you from everybody for a great day of racing here. Then Lovato wins it, the 10-horse London Market. And Lovato, who missed the big ride, Dave, made his day in Maryland worthwhile.
Well, even though Grand Roll didn't run, it comes to the winner's circle once again. In this, the culmination of a great day of Maryland racing, Frank Lovato giving Jeff Weissman a few words about the race and the trophy presentation being made.
Unbelievable. There is young Scott Saban, the president of Thoroughbred Arc, to make the presentation to the connections of London Market. And what a tremendous job they've all done here with Maryland Million Day. Our thanks especially to the officials at Laurel Racecourse, President and CEO Frank DeFrancis, Executive Vice President Bob Manfuso, Vice President Tom Manfuso, to the people of the Maryland Million, our friend President Jim McKay, Executive Director Richard Wilkie. The 10-horse London Market wins the Thoroughbred Arc Maryland Handicap. We'll take a look at how we saw it on this finish, and it was tight. A special thanks to a tremendous job by our production crew. They have pulled off television history today. Never before have 9 races been put in 2 hours. Doug Wren, our director, Steve Nagler, our producer, so many people, Kevin Shank in the truck, along with Sue Belknap, Dorinda Ivey, the people from Packing Crate Productions. They've all done a tremendous job here today. Dave?
And you get 20-40 if you bet London Market, with the four-horse, Tufton second, and Bare Feet third.
Bud Light, the less filling light beer with a first name and taste. Del Rey Estates, the ultimate winner's circle. And the Thoroughbred Arc, your invitation to equine excellence. Laurel Racecourse, racing to be the best. The Ryland Group, Ryland Homes are built for life. Valvoline Motor Oil, where motor oil is not just motor oil. And by Walmack International, winning the world over, all bringing you parts of the Maryland Million today. Hotel accommodations for Thoroughbred Sports provided by the Baltimore Omni International Hotel. We put the more in Baltimore. This has been a Thoroughbred Sports presentation in association with ESPN. For Dave Johnson, for Tom Dawson, for all of us, our Thoroughbred Sports crew, thank you and so long from Maryland.